back to Let's Play Final Fantasy XIV. Here we go. It took like 20 minutes to queue into this, despite a supposed 5-minute wait for the queue time. And here we go into the Orban Monastery. The hardest and highest item level requirement, 24 man, of the level 70 plateau. It's not that hard, but it is pretty fun and fun. But it's got some bosses that have a few tricks that sort of juke people out sometimes and. Man, we really fit all 24 people plus Fran and the other people on that airship. Let's use this real quick. Won't get too far behind. Kind of hate that, like. Using the manual has a cast time, but using food, you know, doesn't. Also, these are some freaky turkeys. And I can't tell if flag just caused my Gurren to completely miss or what. Whatever, shall we do? Apparently not tank. Not have other people tank. And also over... Right, the same Tim. Whoops. Man, no one's tanking. The tanks are tanking. Another wonderful day, I mean. What is it the kids say these days? Great community, by the way. It's like some sort of meme. It isn't really so much that the community is hostile. It's just that indolence and laziness cause a lot of interpersonal drama and things. Like, tanks that don't... They want a tank. They want to get, like... They want a lot on tank gear. They want to, you know, have an easy DPS rotation or whatever. But... They think, oh, well, someone else can just tank. And so they don't do their job at all. It's really fucking annoying. Is that dive? Huh. Oh, it's the coat of casting. I was like, I don't remember that dying like that. I thought it was the ninja coat. My name is Mustadio Bonanza. Mustadio wasn't a robot. What the fuck is this? Or maybe he made one and named it after himself. With it that they add the echo by default. Oh well. It'll help us kill everything faster.
you shall promise. The promise will save you from what comes next.
Sure about that, Bud Row? Can I not meditate during this cutscene? That's dumb. Now this is an interesting mechanic, sort of. You want to actually face the gap in your golden, like, targeting thing towards him? I'm not really sure why that is. Like, if it's supposed to be, like, an iron sight loop or something. But, like, if you face it the other way, then it's instant death. Whatever. Dying pretty slow, despite our echo. I assume it's only like 10% or something. Which, I mean, that's still a lot. But... chose to go the other way. Oh well. Not every tank is good at reading arena mechanics like that, so. I suppose he's gonna die quickly enough that I can just do the LB2.
You have proven yourself deserving of the title. So be brave.
this my journey can, at long last, come to an end.
Okay, so it's like the heroes of Eld that went with Ramza, or use some Orisite or some shit to become guardians of this place to help keep Ultima, the High Seraph, sealed in or something. People took refuge here. Well, where are they? I've never actually read the dialogue.
The Bell of Youth guides your fate, but have you the faith to fulfill his legacy?
I'm not really faithful, Agrius, but you are one of my favorite RPG characters of all time, so I'll try my best. Now we get some really cool voice lines out of Agrius here. That was weird. Didn't see the animation for that.
To the current of life we succumb. Its judgment swift and final. Its bite as cold as steel.
Fauna! Nice. Direct crit on Hasatsu Gurren. It's always a good thing. Wow, the animation just goes off really quickly. Okay. You have fun cleansing them, Chicky. I grabbed the sword, but I'm in prison.
Seven shadows cast, seven fates foretold, but at the end of the broken path like death, and death alone!
There you go. I dashed through, but afraid latency would kill me. Tear my flesh asunder any time, if you know what I'm saying.
The dreams of men are fleeting, yet they must be embraced if they are to flourish. Have you the faith to do as much?
Sure don't. Be asking if I got faith, babe. Not that kind of guy. I used to be. Used to be quite fervent.
into the light!
Oh sure, take forever. Have Third Eye wear off. I really wish they would extend Third Eye to being a 10-second cooldown.
Well, a lot have spoken. Let their words echo in your empty soul. Ruination is come!
It doesn't make Sam some sort of unstoppable, like, god or anything. So, like, I mean... So the 3-second thing, like, you can miss triggering it, because, like, when you're... Even when you're solo, because fucking auto attacks and latency from the server registering not only you taking the hit, but you executing the ability.
On guard!
Oh, come on. I don't want to do this phase, even if it is good to show it off for the LP. You didn't get to finish that phase. But basically, you just keep killing the ghosts. And, eventually, you come back out. And if you don't kill the ghosts, then you die from the doom. Or you get stacks that cause you to die or something. Oh, very pretty out here. What did Fran say? Here it feels different than the monastery above. Otherworldly? One far beyond our kin, huh? Is it beyond our kin if we already know what it is? Like, we already know it's down here. Why would it be beyond our understanding? Suits of armor. Dark Crusader. Hey look, it's Google Library time. Ah, people are dumb. That's okay. It'll just make the trash phase last longer, that's all. Break didn't do jack shit to him. I mean, it did like 6% of his HP, I guess, but he's got a lot of HP for being a trash boss. Also, I wish you could get a sword. I don't think that sword's available on any of the sword jobs. Yeah. once when I was very young, I heard elders speak of a dark city where the horrors that haunt our nightmares dwell. The Necro Hall of Mulande.
Your coming was foretold, servant of Ivalice. Or perhaps you serve another. I am Count Sidolphus Orlando. Your journey ends here.
Got some cool swords there.
The hearts of men are black with corruption and must needs be cleansed.
This here is a little doom. It has to be fully healed off. And our white mages aren't doing their job. Well, one of them isn't.
I call out to the skies and tremble as the brilliance of a
and
thousand bolts blinds mine enemies and tears their flesh asunder.
Ouch.
To the current of life we succumb, its judgment swift and final. Its bite as cold as steel. Open your eyes to the darkness and drown in its loveless embrace. The gods will not be watching. Misfortune hangs heavy on a head once held high. Such is poor cover for when the heavens fall. Come, show me more. Seven shadows cast, seven fates foretold. Yet at the end of the broken path lies death, and death alone. Live by the sword is to die by the sword. There is time enough for regret in the flames of hell. Honed is the blade that severs the villain's head. Endless is the path that leads him from hell.
His ad phase, he splits into three, you know, doppelganger looking fellows. Each party is like dead even. Yeah, it works for me.
I have been called the God of Thunder. You will now know why. Upon my holy blade, the very world lies in balance. And now the scales will tip.
Merely the beginning, huh? Well, that was the first half. That's what you mean.
Come, show me more. Escape is not so easily granted.
Thank you.
you expecting a modicum of rust? You will find my defenses quite impenetrable. A piteous display. They who dwell aloft have spoken. Let their words echo in your empty soul. Ruination is come. Strongest of shields cannot defend the weakest of wills. A moment's hesitation beckons a lifetime of pain. Defense is quite impenetrable.
Uh-oh. Yep, saw that coming.
The screams of ruin rise above the storm's discord. Shudder not in her endless cold.
Currently taking endgame info, huh? Sometimes I wish I had queued as healer, specifically for this fight. But, I didn't.
Were you expecting a modicum of rust? You will find my defenses quite impenetrable. Escape is not the clouds have parted, and the skies cleared. This is time I bade you farewell.
Holy night boots? Whatever. Oh, 99 greed. That'll do me some good if I win it, but... like one of the other healers doesn't need, basically.
Is it sanctum you seek, my wayward children? Or perhaps you are come in search of power?
5 Orisites. Whoa, whoa. Actually, a lot more Orisites.
That which lies at your feet, that blessed bauble can grant you both. You need but will it so. Now. Take up your salvation and be gone. mortal agency in matters divine shall not be suffered.
Don't know what that Kaido person is saying. It's always been three, but... Some people like to tell good old day stories, but actually knowing what the good old days were like.
Kneel before me.
I seem sort of low energy, I'm sorry.
Denizens of the Abyss, from ink of blackest night, I suffer.
Hey look, it's first boss from River Moana Lighthouse.
Kneel before me.
Denizens of the Abyss, from ink of blackest night, I Dimmy Belias. Kinda like how Summoner has, Dimmy, Bahamut and whatnot.
Denizens of the Abyss, from ink of blackest night, I suffer.
Both towers falling the other way.
Death awaits defiance.
I love when I'm not the target of a mechanic. You could also, if you were wanting to meditate on Samurai, you could just wait. They all start to charge their ults. But then what's this? Sid, Agrius, and Mustadio all appear again and kill them till they die from it.
Bear your steel!
Yeah, she's been weaving them. Now this right here is about to be a healer check. And one of our white mages just hasn't been using lucid dreaming at all. So it's gonna be up to Katsuki basically.
You will not intervene.
Not quite.
I am the only god.
I Ramses. Pulling the Jesus.
Few can claim to have endured the might of my will.
Well, she's large and in charge.
Denizens of the Abyss, from Ink of Blackest Night, I summon you. Kneel before me.
Now you're incentivized to do this because if too many of these get missed, it's a wipe. But also, it gives you a DPS buff. At least I think it does. I'm pretty sure it's pretty substantial too. But don't quote me on that. Be sending us to like a shadow dimension in a second here.
Bend to my will.
Oh wow, I actually. Maybe if I'd had knockback resistance on. Pretty epic, isn't it? Just wish I could angle the camera correctly to see her actual, face up there. Blood, Vanquisher. My Vanquisher in time's long past.
Denizens of the Abyss, from Ink of Blackest Night, I summon.
Yay! We did it! Woo!
I am your maker. I am Ivalice. Consign me unto darkness, and your light will be forever lost.
Word. When I first did this, this absolutely blew me away. Like, I was, like, so blown away that I ran this dungeon, like, 5 billion times. And now it's sort of just blasé to me. But I'm also kind of feeling a little bit under the weather for some reason today. I think it's because I've been having trouble sleeping again the last few days. Katsuki did a pretty good job. Ooh, wind up Ramza. We don't really got any good lots. But we'll see if we win anything. Oh, we won a card. Fair skies, huh? That took 40 minutes. Goodness gracious. So we got, what, like 20 left? Almost? Eh, no commendations. Well, whatever. Hey, there's the guy what we was gonna save. Not only because the scriptwriter said so. I'm pretty sure when I played through Final Fantasy Tactics last time, I had you one-shot Ultima with dual-wield monk fists or something. Or maybe it was ninja swords. I'm kind of sad that they made Agrias a Midlander. I think she would be a Highlander. In stature. Midlanders are ridiculously small. Like, their max height setting is like 5'4" or something. Oh look, it's like every side character ever from Tactics. It's like Melia Duel and her brother and the Chocobo. Got Construct 7 in the background. What the fuck? Construct 7 has a soul? WTF! They got the ethnicity on the Melia Duel twins. Am I remembering their name right? It's, you know, it's like the Near Eastern, like, they use like special sword techniques that are basically holy sword, but specifically for breaking equipment. The feck? No, don't say that. Delete is a douchebag. Maybe in this alternate reality you're sorry, but in the original Final Fantasy Tactics, you are an unrepentant bastard. Thank you. Yep, me and the 23 other wolves. Man, I don't even know if we're going to get through all the cutscenes, right? Because that was like another 5 to 10 minutes of cutscene just now. You had my commentary. We've got like 10 minutes left. And you know how Stormblood cutscenes be. Fucking take 80 billion years. One eternity later. Did that reporter seriously just tell Sid to cut it out? Get the fuck out of here, you stupid reporter. Mother crystal clear. Well, the mother crystal is like solid blue and you can't see through it, so clearly the Moogles are confused. Yep, they sure are. I don't control the speed at which this dialogue goes. So, if it goes too fast, they're at the bottom. Sorry. literally that airship lugs an entire viewing amphitheater on top of it. Meanwhile, in the Clockwork City of Gug, Imperial Sky Armors, and a lot of them for some reason. And their pilots are all out of them. Construct graveyard. Hey, look, there's a guy in armor. Noah Van Gabranth, huh? Hey, isn't that one of the guys from the playwright ship? Tartarus, huh? Oh, is this the same thing you said before? Yeah, it is. Okay. Okay. Stop it. Stop it. Snap it. I guess I should have shown you more of the acting crew so that we could have recognized that actor that was showing the Garleans around. So it means there's a traitor aboard the stage company, or a spy. God, reporters are scummy. Well, anyway, there's not really enough time at all to do anything else. So I think I'll cut it here. Next time, I think I'll open up with, I think we'll go back to doing... We'll go ahead and wrap up Tortoise in Time, out in the Ruby Sea. And try to get the next... Well, the last remaining... Well, not last remaining. There's three more trials to get for Stormblood. Actually four more if you include the Hildebrand one, I guess. But two of them are behind Tortoise in Time. So we're going to do that next recording. And, I guess until then, stay safe and have a nice day.